ChatGPT-5 has officially landed, and it's packing some incredible new capabilities. OpenAI says it's their smartest, fastest, and most useful model yet. And today, we're putting those claims to the test. I'm Kevin, and let's dive in. You can start using GPT-5 right now on your computer, and it's completely free. Just head to chatgpt.com and then sign in. GPT-5 is now the default model. If you're on the free plan, you'll have full GPT-5 access until you hit your daily limit, somewhere around 30 messages a day. And then it automatically switches to GPT-5 mini, so you can keep going without interruption. On your phone, just install or update to the latest ChatGPT app. Once you open a new chat, GPT-5 is the default model. No settings to change and no hoops to jump through. So let's talk about what's new with GPT-5. OpenAI says this is the smartest and fastest model yet, and it's now all unified. If you used ChatGPT in the past, you might remember that there were multiple models to choose from. You had your generalized models, reasoning, and mini models. You had to guess which one was the best one to use. But now, GPT-5 automatically adjusts how deeply it thinks based on your question. If it's a quick request, it responds fast. If it's something more complex, it kicks you into deeper reasoning. You don't have to think about which one to use. Behind the scenes, though, GPT-5 is actually two different models, and it picks the right model or intent without needing to ask you. If you're a paid user, you still have the ability to choose GPT-5 thinking mode. That gives you extended reasoning power. OpenAI says that GPT-5 outperforms the O3 reasoning model and GPT-4.5 on both reasoning and creativity. Now, at least personally, I thought both of those models worked very well, so that's quite the statement. They also say that it's more reliable with fewer hallucinations. There's only one way to know, though. Let's test it out. Let's try prompt right down below. Let's see if it can make a Tetris game for my company, the Kevin Cookie Company. And here's a twist. Instead of using the traditional Tetris blocks, let's see if it could use cookie images for the pieces. Also, I'd like for it to include my branding. Over here, I'll drag and drop in the logo of the Kevin Cookie Company, and let's test this out. Over on the left-hand side, we can see that it generated a full cookie-themed Tetris game using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Now, it looks like it did not manage to include the logo, but everything else appears to be in place. Over on the right, I can review the code itself, and I think it looks great. The formatting is clean, the comments are helpful, and if we go all the way to the top, oh, look at that! It even pulled the brand colors directly from the logo. Even though it couldn't insert the logo itself, it was still able to pull the colors. Okay, let's give it a try. In the top right, let's run the code. There they are. Look at that. Cookie pieces tumbling down the screen. Scrolling down, I can see the controls all right there, so that way I know how to play. All right, let's play some Tetris. And honestly, this is really remarkable. Now, GPT-5 isn't the only thing launching today. ChatGPT itself is getting some other big upgrades. First, you can now connect Gmail and Google Calendar. Click on your profile, then Settings, and then Connectors. And here you'll see Gmail and Google Calendar. So, what can you do with that? You can now ask ChatGPT to, let's say, summarize your last 5 unread emails, or let's say, find a 2-hour meeting slot for next week. You could also ask it to draft a reply to an email from Sarah in accounting. This is rolling out to pro users first, with more plans to follow later. Second, you can customize ChatGPT's personality and even change the chat color. That way, it feels more like your personal assistant. Now, this wasn't available yet when I was testing it out. Third, voice mode has gotten an upgrade, and it's now called Advanced Voice Mode. In the chat, click on the voice mode icon.
Hey there, Kevin. How's it going?
We need to launch a new cookie flavor for the Kevin Cookie Company. Any recommendations on types of cookies to launch?
Ooh, that sounds fun. You could go for something seasonal, like a pumpkin spice cookie if it's autumn, or maybe a fun twist on a classic, like a s'mores cookie with gooey marshmallow and chocolate chunks.
Do you think we could include something like bacon bits in the cookie or jalapenos? What about bacon-wrapped jalapenos? dipped in chocolate.
That sounds like a bold and adventurous combination. Bacon bits can definitely add a savory crunch to a cookie, and jalapenos would give it a spicy kick. Bacon wrapped jalapeno dipped in chocolate is definitely unique and could be a fun limited edition flavor. It could be a hit with people who love that sweet and spicy combo.
It kind of sounds like you're telling me it's terrible.
Oh, no, not at all. I think it's actually really creative and unique. Sometimes those unexpected combinations end up being the most memorable and exciting. So I say go for it.
Would you bet the business on it?
Well, I think it's always fun to experiment with bold flavors, but maybe it's best to test it out as a limited edition first and see how people respond.
And finally, there's a new study mode. This gives you step-by-step personalized help to learn anything, let's say from coding to baking. This is already live for everyone. To use study mode, in the chat, click on the plus icon, and then down below, go to all of your tools. And here we have the option called study and learn. I'll toggle that on. And right over here, let's ask if it could help me learn how to bake a chocolate chip cookie. Let's send that. It'll now walk me through step by step how to learn how to do this. So down below, I'll tell it it's my first time, and then we'll go back and forth with these prompts. Now right here, you'll see how it guides me through the entire process step by step, and it continues prompting me until I learn how to do this. And there you go, your first look at GPT-5 and some of the new tricks coming to ChatGPT. Now, if you found this video helpful, please give it a like, please consider subscribing, and as always, remember to keep your cookie jars full.